Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Mr. Deputy Speaker, we are debating today the adjournment motion proposed by Honourable Sumandiran relating to the Provincial Council election system that we have introduced recently and are caught up in a dilemma as to proper implementation of that system, since it is in a state of limbo, having not presented the delimitation committee's report, though having presented it in March, we are now well past the time frame within which this particular report should have been discussed and passed. Having said that, Mr. Deputy Speaker, in our country, ever since adult franchise was introduced, we have been having different systems of elections at different periods of time. But subsequently, of late, we have now come to a position where virtually the country has become a veritable laboratory for testing out election systems. None of these tests have become positive for the reason that we cannot address the concerns of different sections of the people, different communities, and there are complaints about the features of whatever systems we introduce. But of late, the system that we introduced, even in the process, I have pointed out, it was introduced very surreptitiously, without even the majority of the members knowing as to what they were going to do. All of a sudden, in the pretext of introducing some amendments, which was originally in the order paper, relating to women representation, entire new system of election was stealthily and surreptitiously introduced to the House. I was one of those people, a party leader, who had taken strong objections to the process in which that Provincial Council election law was brought to the House and introduced. We made several protests, and having got some assurances from the Prime Minister that we will look at all the concerns that the minority communities have, particularly the dispersed communities like the upcountry Tamils and the Muslims, who had been very serious issues pertaining to the new system. They agreed to even convert the proportion of first-past-the-post electorates to that of the proportional representation seats from the amended 60-40 proportion was to be amended further to 50-50. And having observed what happened in the local government elections under the new system on the 10th of February, it became very clear to most of us that the new system, though was meant to get rid of variety of negative features, it further aggravated the existing situation. For instance, the amount of money spent on a territorial constituency, a ward. Now, we expected, now if we got rid of the preferential voting system, the tendency for giving inducements to voters would be reduced. But what we observed was the tendency to induce voters became much easier. It was within a limited territorial ward. People started doling out money and various other inducements to buy votes. This is what we observed. And the Election Commission was quite aware. Even religious places of worship, mosques, Buddhist temples, Hindu temples, churches, all became places where you could do political activity. There were some specific instances where we even took up objections with the Election Commission and they sent special observers. There were several letters exchanged between the returning officers in that area to prevent such abuse taking place. But the electoral abuse was increased manifold despite the fact that these were to be addressed through a new system. Now, looking at this delimitation committee report, I must point out that we have only got the volume one of the delimitation committee report that has been tabled. There is a further volume which contains representations made by various different organizations in every district. We are not furnished with that second volume for us to examine whether sufficient attention has been paid by the delimitation committee to the observations and memoranda submitted by different organizations at district level. Now, this includes not only political parties, civil society organizations, individuals. These had to be placed before the House for us to have a complete discussion. But in any event, this is only an exercise in hindsight. The relevant period within which this should be debated had passed, and now we have almost 5 months elapsed since the presentation of the delimitation committee report. So that is one matter. Then also the Provincial Council Elections Amendment Act number 17 of 2017 proposes to consider multi-member electorate in demarcation. The committee deliberately turned down all the proposals for multi-member electorates made by us in many places. For instance, Akkaraipattu Pottuvil, Mavanalla, then Deltota Hevahatta, Gaul, Kuliapitiya, for example. These areas we made very valid presentations to create multi-member electorates to accommodate minority representation in those areas. Those were turned down without giving sufficient reasons. Then the criteria defined to demarcate the electorates by the Delimitation Commission were very unrealistic and fundamentally wrong. Population range for an electorate, for instance, was determined very arbitrarily. Some criteria for majority and the minorities living in geographically scattered areas had been determined without sufficient concern for the need to create smaller electorates or to ensure multi-member constituencies are created. Also, they have rejected some proposals saying that we have no mandate to divide a historical area into two electorates. For instance, in Polonnaruwa, we made a very, very strong representation in order to have at least one member from the Muslim community elected from the Lankapura area and from certain adjoining areas, dividing certain Grama Sevaka divisions. That was even turned down. Up to date, we have been having continuously certain members elected. Now, we have today a document that the Honorable Speaker has circulated to all the members of Parliament, which have been received from the Chairman of the Delimitation Commission, which very clearly enunciate what type of injustice will be done to smaller communities. Now, I can refer to the Muslim community here. Now, in his letter, he very clearly lays out, there is a table which is in the very first page of the letter submitted by the Chairman of the Delimitation Commission. Now, the last provincial council election, number of members returned to each provincial council on behalf of the Muslim community was 43. But the proposed electorates for the 50% electorates in the new system, they have been able to demarcate only 13 in the entire country. Only 13 electorates, whereas we have had 43 members in all the provincial councils in the previous election. Now, if you add the further 50%, it will become 26 members. That is far below the 43 members we have had in the earlier system. And this has seriously done injustice when you look at the Muslim community's interest alone. But if you look at the upcountry Tamils, too, this issue will arise. Of course, they have not divided the upcountry Tamils separately. They have not shown it separately, perhaps for the reason that they have put them into the same category as Tamils and has given a table here for us to look at to see how the representation will get affected. And it has already got affected by this delimitation that has already been done.
You have one more minute, Honourable
Mr. Deputy Speaker, I have two other members who are speaking on behalf of my party.
Right.
Somewhere down the line, I'll take their time as well.
Okay.
So, we suspect that whether the committee works on a fixed agenda, demarcation done prior to public announcement. That is how we see what has happened here. Because they have had a particular mindset with which they have approached this issue, because only a limited period was available. Such an exercise will have to take several months to complete. But since they were forced to complete within a particular period of time, they ignored a variety of different representations that were made, very valid and justifiable representations that have been made on behalf of different communities have been turned down arbitrarily by the Commission. It failed to accommodate the very reasonable appeal of political parties, civil society organizations and individuals. The committee divided and negated the appeal proposals of renowned scholar and a Muslim representative, Professor Hasbullah, who was there as a member of the commission. And he too was talking to us in a very dejected mindset, saying that his appeals fell on deaf ears. And that is, of course, he may not admit it in public, but then this is something that he shared with us whenever we had discussions with him on this issue. Therefore, the way in which they have advised themselves to do this report, and it is very evident and very obvious for all of us to see from the very from the report that the chairman himself has sent to the speaker as to how the impact of this is going to affect different communities. So this is quite apparent for all of us to see. Therefore, to convince the Muslim community to accept this report is impossible as far as we are concerned. Therefore, what we are asking is that we totally ignore this new system and get back to the old system. And I must also very clearly say here, there are a variety of parties who are attempting to continue to tinker with this new system and to refine it further in order to appease various different sections and to hold elections thereafter. The purpose they are, I must say very clearly. Mama na kiyanne one niyojya kathanayakathumani me tiyana aluth kramaya vivida akarein api sankshodhan idiripat karala navata eke thiyena adupadu sakasala apata me seema nirnaya commission vaarthawa yam vidihakin me parliamentuwata navata idiripat kirima sandaha navata ara committee pat karala karaganna puluwan kiyana saavare inna samahara පක්ෂ මේ සභාගර්භය තුල ඉන්න පුළුවන් එහෙම ඉන්න කට්ටිය මේක වෙනම උපරවැට්ටියක් සඳහා පාවිච්චි කරන ක්‍රමවේදයක් කියනයි අපිට නම් හිතන්නේ මොකද ඒකෙන් කිසිදාක අපට නිසි වෙලාවට මේ මැතිවරණය තබා ගැනීමට හැකි වෙන්නේ නැහැ කියන එක ඉතාම පැහැදිලි. එබැවින් අපි නම් ඉල්ලා සිටින්නේ මීට කලිනුත් කිව්වා මේක දැන් අපි අපේ පරණ විතාන මන්ත්‍රීම කතා කරද්දී කිව්වා මේ ලංකාව දැන් මැතිවරණ ක්‍රම පරිශීනාගාරයක් වෙලා කියලා. ඒතරම් දුරට අපි දැන් නොයෙක් ක්‍රම පිළිබඳව දැන් අත්හදා බැලීම කරගෙන යන මේ යුගයක අපට කලට වේලාවට මැතිවරණක් තිබිය යුතු නම් අපි මේ අතගගා මේ අලුත් මැතිවරණ ක්‍රමයේ තියෙන අඩුපාඩු හදාගන්න කරන මේ උත්සාහය පැත්තක තියලා අපි පරණ ක්‍රමයට යා යුතුයි කියන එක මම තරයෙන්ම අවධාරණය කරනවා ඒ තුලින් තමයි යම් සාධාරණයක් කාටත් ඉතිවිය හැකි මොකද මේකෙන් අපි ඉවත් කරන්නට හැදූ සමහර ලක්ෂණ ඒකෙන් ඇති වුණු අඩුපාඩු මේ ක්‍රමයේ තියෙන බව අපිට පෙනියනවා අපි පළාත් පාලන මැතිවරණයේ දැක්ක දෙයක් තමයි සෑහෙන දුරට දූෂණ සිදු වුණා. ඒ දූෂණ අපිට වැළැක්වීමට බැරි වුණා. සුළු කොට්ටාසය තුල නොයෙකුත් ආකාරයේ දීමනා දෙමින් ඒ කොට්ටාසවල දිනා ගැනීම සඳහා අපේක්ෂකවරු උත්සාහ කරපු බව අපිට පැහැදිලිව පෙනුණා.
ඒක වළක්වාගෙන බැරි වුණා. මොකද මනාම ක්‍රමයේ තියෙන අඩුපාඩු වලට වඩා දූෂණ සිදු වුණු ක්‍රමයක් හැටියටයි අපි අලුත් ක්‍රමයේ දකින්නේ. එබැවින් අපි නැවත පරණ ක්‍රමයට යාම තුලින් තමයි කලට වේලාවට මැතිවරණයක් තබා ගන්නට හැකි වෙන්නේ කියන එක මම ඉතාම වගකීමකින් යුතුව අවධාරණය කරනවා. අපි මේ තියෙන අලුත් ක්‍රමය හදන්න ගිහිල්ලා අපට කිසි විටක මේ දෙසැම්බර් වෙනකොට මැතිවරණයක් තියුණායි කියලා කවුරු කිව්වත් ඒක වෙන්නේ නැහැයි කියන එක පැහැදිලි. ඉතින් ඒ වගේ ප්‍රෝඩාවකට ශ්‍රී ලංකා මුස්ලිම් කොංග්‍රසයේ එකතු වීමට කවදත් සූදානම් නැහැ කියන එක මම ඊටම පැහැදිලිව කියා සිටිනවා. නමුත් ඉතින් මන්නම් කියන්නේ මන්ත්‍රීතුමනි මේ අපි මේ මැතිවරණ ක්‍රමවල පරිේශනාගාරයක් හැටියට මේ රට පවත්වගෙන යන තත්වයකට දැන් ඇවිල්ලා ඉන්නේ. ඒක පැත්තක තියලා අපි පරණ ක්‍රමයට යෑම තුලින් තමයි අපට කාටත් යුක්තියක් ඉටු කරන්න සිදු වෙන්නේ. මොකද අපේ සමාජයට මුස්ලිම් ප්‍රජාවට විශාල අසාධාරණයක් මේ සීමාර්ණණය තුළ සිදු වෙලා තියෙනවා. 43 දෙනෙක් හිටපු තැන 13 දෙනෙක්. දැන් සීමාර්ණණය කමිටු වාර්තාව සභාපතිතුමාගේ වාර්තාව ඉතාම පැහැදිලිව කියනවා. 13යි අපිට මේ කොට්ටාස වෙන් කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙලා තිබෙන්නේ. ඉතින් එහෙම තත්වයක් උඩදී අපට කිසිසේත්ම පුළුවන්කමක් නැහැ මේකට එකඟ වෙන්න. අපි පරණ ක්‍රමයට යා යුතුයි. එහෙම යාම තුල තමයි එක එක උප්පර වැට්ටි එක එක්කෙනා කරන්න කියන්න පුළුවන්. කරාට මම ඉතාලි පැහැදිලිව අපි කිව්වා. පක්ෂ නායකවුන් අපි ආණ්ඩු පක්ෂයේ ඉන්න පක්ෂ නායකව රැස් වුණා. අපේ ආණ්ඩුවේ ප්‍රධානීන් හමු වුණා. හමු වෙලා කතා කරද්දී අපි ඉතාලි පැහැදිලිව කිව්වා. මේක අපි අත ගගා ඉන්න බෑ. කෙලින්ම අපි පරණ ක්‍රමයට ගිහිල්ලා කලට වේලාවට මැතිවරණේ තියලා ජනතාවට මුණ දීලා අපි එන ප්‍රතිඵලය පිළිගමු කියන එක අපි තාම පැහැදිලි අවධාරණය කරලා තියෙනවා. අපි නම් මේ අලුත් ක්‍රමය තුළ කිසි විටක මේ සුළු ජාතීන්ට සාධාරණයක් වෙන්නේ නැහැ කියන එක අවධාරණය කරමින් මගේ කතාව මම අවසන් කරනවා. ස්තුතියි.